yes, if you check the thumbnail, it says it right. I fasted for 18 days, and by fasting I mean I did not eat anything or consume anything of any calorific value, and all I got to drink was gallons and gallons of water. Why I did it? Well, I'm going to make a separate video about it. This particular video is about my journey, like, you know, how those days went. Because when you talk to somebody and tell them you've not had food, the first thing they say, are you insane? That's not healthy. Don't do this. You know, there are a lot of schools of thoughts there. But I did it for my own personal journey on various reasons. I've always been someone, I've done this before, to be very honest. And I've always been someone who usually tries to take a more natural path for things rather than, you know, getting in, you know, just chumming down medicines down me. So that was not for me. And I was facing issues. I've always had a very flawless skin, and I ended up having acne. And not just any acne, cystic acne, the kinds that actually pained. And I felt, for the first time, I felt the agony that actually people have when they have acne, the insecurity they have. No, I have always considered myself to be absolutely beautiful, but it was something I didn't like. And when you don't like something, you try and change. And there's nothing wrong in it. Of course, I'm obese and very much visible. I'm chubby. So yes, that was one of the reasons. That was not the primary reasons. The primary reason for me doing it was to give my body a reboot, like a reset button, you know, like 18 days, let my body just do what it does best. It heals. My body is a doctor of its own. We all have it. It's genetically imbibed in us. We just don't think about it because we're so used to just eating food and putting it down our throat. If it's a candy, if it's a chocolate cake, if it's a samosa, something or the other. And I realized that that's not going to help me. If I really wanted to change myself, I'll have to change the way, the first most important thing I do, eat. So I realized if eating and trying different medications was not helping, then definitely let's resort to the other issue. Let's not eat. And I did not eat for 18 days, and it was a fantastic journey, a journey for which I will always be grateful to Almighty God, because He gave me the strength to do it. And I was not at a retreat where, you know, I had other activities. I was right at my home with my kids during this corona pandemic, and, you know, I was able to watch people eat food, everything. It took a lot of strength, but you know what? I'm so proud of myself that I did it. I am so, so, so proud of myself. It's a very enlightening journey for me, very emotional. As you'll see, that there's a wave of emotion that goes by. It's very emotional, very enlightening. I'm very happy I did it. So please do watch it. And if you like it, I'll be doing a series about it. I'm going to make an integral part of it. This is my second long fast. I have done short fasts, but this is a longer fast that I've done. And I'm going to be making more videos about naturopathy, how to deal with natural cures, how to take care of yourself with yoga. I'm not going to talk about pumping iron because honestly, a lot of people don't have that kind of time. But a natural way of taking care of yourself with exercising, or, you know, 20 minutes to yourself, skincare, which is again very important. You know, things that we actually deal in real life. And yes, most important, fasting. I will be talking a lot about fasting, how you can make it as a part of your daily life without actually compromising about the small joys of going to a party of a friend. So yes, please watch this and leave a comment down below if there's some question that you have, or you want me to, you know, address a certain concern, anything. Let's just get talking. And I really hope you enjoy. If you do, please, please, please do subscribe. I know I'm supposed to say it the last. It's my first video, so I'm saying it in the beginning. Please do subscribe. Press that bell icon. I'm going to leave an Insta comment where I put some pictures and everything to keep people updated, if in case you're interested in being updated by my life. Yes, so please, please, please do watch it. And thank you so much. Namaste. Hi, it's time for the second check-in. It's 6 o'clock. So technically I had my last meal yesterday at 6. It's 24 hours. I'm just trying to stay calm and not jinx it, because I can do that, or at least just say I'm kind of that person who thinks I can jinx things for myself. So yeah, 24 hours, and I'll do the last check-in at night before going off to bed, so we know how it goes. But on that note, energy is good. I think I've almost had about 5 liters of water. I'm anyways a lot of water person, but they say that, you know, you drinking a lot of water and still feeling thirsty is actually an electrolyte imbalance. So I've added electrolytes to my water so that I don't feel like deprived, and I need to feel nourished and hydrated. So yeah, so far the body's still running on glycogen, so definitely not kicked into ketosis, but looking forward to the journey. Hello, good morning, and welcome to day 2. And if I sound too energetic,
It's 7 in the morning. Yes, I slept early yesterday. I was feeling very tired, so I just dozed off. But on that note, I was feeling very cold, so I couldn't sleep in my own room because the AC was blasting on 25. I know how that sounds, blasting on 25. But yeah, so I had to sleep in my kid's room for that reason, and I still had a blanket and the fan was on too, literally. So I was feeling very cold, but I'm up and awake. It's 7 in the morning. Nobody in the house is awake, so it's pretty quiet and peaceful at the moment. And I'm enjoying my breakfast, H2O. The only choice I have is trying and changing different cups and adding a bit of salt for change. Yeah, other than that, yes, I did dream of food. I was munching on chocolate fudge. But till the time I'm just eating in my dreams, I think we're good to go. So yes, day two has begun. And, you know, the more days go in, the more you feel, you know, you're going ahead in your journey. So yes, again, keeping the fingers crossed, everything stays good and calm. And I'll do a check-in later today. Hi, so the day two has come to end. I just got in some steps, about 5,000. So the noticing thing for today, I did happen to have a little bit of pain or heaviness or tightness in my calves. But other than that, it was good. I'm good. Packing in for tonight, check in with you guys tomorrow. Good night. Good morning, the day three has begun. So the only thing to notice about last night is I had to go to the loo multiple times just to pee, to urinate, because I was drinking so much of water. So I think I'll have to keep a check on that as the night proceeds, I should drink a little less water, because you know, we're not eating food. So it kind of maybe is our tendency of the human mind to drink water to feel satiated. But I'll try and decrease the water, because I think I went to the loo like 5 times last night and my sleep was, it had really gone for toss. So I'm not feeling as fresh, but yeah, everything else was just fine. Of course, I was feeling cold, so I couldn't sleep in the AC again. That's for it. And let's update at evening or at night and see how it goes. Hi guys. So checking out for the day four, I went for a walk, did about 8,000 steps. So I kind of start feeling sleepy. I noticed around, you know, around 4-5-ish. I thought it was just the initial days, but I even had it today. Let's see how long it continues. So I just go for a walk at around 7 or 8 so that I can sleep comfortably and, you know, not stay awake all night. Secondly, the second thing that I noticed was I had acid reflux all day long today. But I did not consume any baking soda this time. But I would not say all day long, but majority part of it. But I kind of like didn't bother. When I was walking, of course, it was not there. Second thing, every time I smell food, the acid reflux is evident. Like, I notice it. It's like my, you know, my nose just smells and all the gastric juices start to brew up. So yeah, that's for that. But yeah, so far the energy is good. I told you about my evening crash of energy. But yeah, I'm able to walk and I think it's good to walk. No point just, you know, staying at home and being all lazy. So, you know, walking keeps you healthy. And as for the muscle, if you don't use it, you lose it. So let me use whatever muscles I have. And that's it for the day four. See you tomorrow, day five. Good morning guys, so it's day 5, huh? It seems like a big number to me because usually the first few days are very difficult. So yeah, day 5, I'm kind of very happy. No update for last night except for that I was cold, the energy was fine, there were no pain or aches whatsoever. I had a bit of shoulder ache yesterday, mild, but it's gone in the morning anyway. Other than that, I'll give an update on my skin as well. Probably in a day or two, so you know, we have a weekly difference as to how it started. But yeah, that's for that, and I'll check in with you guys in the evening or at night depending on how the day goes. Yeah, so day 5, good morning, day 6. I couldn't do a check-in yesterday, so yeah, so yesterday basically I had a lot of acid reflux. And I mean, in the Western world, the remedy is you drink apple cider vinegar or have baking soda. So I had tried these both earlier when I told you, I think on the fourth day I had acid reflux and they didn't do much. So I went back to the typical Indian Ayurvedic nuska. I just boiled a small slice of ginger and about half a teaspoon of cumin, boiled it and had it. And it was sorted. So I had no acid reflux thereof. As for yesterday, I did some steps, about 8,000 walked. The energy was fine. It was all perfect. I have a bit of shoulder pain. I don't know why. It's stiff.
I've had it sometimes, but it's a little more than usual. Maybe the inflammation has gone up or something like that. But I'll keep you updated on that. And the most important, skin. Well, the skin's gotten better. I used to have small pustules here. If you can see marks, there were small, small things. None. It's clear. There's nothing. No, nothing. There's no new acne that has come up. Whatever is there, it's now healing. But yeah, no new acne, and this really healing well. So yeah, day 6 has begun. Let's see how far the journey goes and how does it go. I'm really excited to rediscover myself. Hello, so day 7, nighttime skin routine done and check-in time. Day 7, one word, shit. It was a shitty day. I was pissed, I was agitated, I just didn't want to see food. I was hating anybody who was eating food. I was like, why are they eating food? Why can't I eat food? One of those grumpy days. I had a grumpy day, and boy, I had a super grumpy day. So I was so grumpy, I was like, I'm not going to do anything. I'm not going to talk to anyone. I'm not going to do this. I'm not going to do that. And luckily, I mean, I don't cook or anything. So, I mean, seriously, thank heavens. Otherwise, it would have been torture for me to cook and not eat. So that was the one thing. I just went down for a stroll with my husband because I was feeling... I mean, there was a like gloomy feeling that I was having. And I was like, I need to shake this feeling. So we went down for a stroll. That's about it. On the other note, health-wise, it was just fine. It's the feeling. And it does happen. There's always a wave of emotion that comes during a water fast. And I know that because this is my second water fast. I've had one. And that too also handled my very crucial health issues in my life. Or probably which I'll make a video again for that. But this time I told my mind, listen, dude, if you're going to crib and cry over a piece of food, over some dish that's there, you've seen on a photo, or people are eating, it's never going to work. The food is never going to go anywhere. But journeys are epic. You just don't leave it like that. This journey is worth it because it's like discovering yourself. It's finding the best in you. It's doing something for yourself. So food, it's going to be there. It's going to be any day that you want to eat. The food is so dirt cheap anywhere these days. But health, trust me, that's pretty expensive. You get a surgery done, it's going to cost you much more bucks than just a piece that's going to put you in that situation. And I realized that. So I explained it to myself. I met it in. I was like, sorted. Fine. But yeah, I'm glad the day is done. And I'm looking forward to a very positive and chirpy day 8. So yeah, done and done. And see you guys tomorrow. Good morning, day 8. And the first update of the day is I woke up in the morning. And I was waiting because, you know, it's not ever happened in the last 3 months that in 3 days I don't get even a single booger in my face. Like, either there has to be pustule or whitehead or a cyst or something. And today marks 3 complete days and nothing is sprouted in my face. Nothing. Like, and in fact, I feel like the pores have gotten smaller, tighter. You know, the skin feels, it feels like it used to be. It's smoother and everything. Like how I used to have it before I ended up having cystic acne. So it's smoother, it's tighter. The pores, like you can see, they're small. They're not like those, like when you have acne, you get these really big pores here. But it's got nothing to do with acne. People with healthy skin also have a lot of those. So that's gone. And yeah, I think even the scars are fading pretty well on their own. Thank God for autophagy. So yeah, that's day 8. That's the update for now. Let's see how the day goes. Hello people, day 8. What an awesome day, huh? What an energy. I could walk for even a longer time. I walked 7 kilometers today. Like, yes, 7 kilometers. And I'm not tired. I'm not freaking tired. My feet don't hurt. Nothing. I can just walk. What an amazing feeling. It's fabulous. The burst of energy, it's a different level. Yes, I was thirsty. Thirsty. I almost gulped down like at least 6 liters of water. But the day that I've been looking for, the positive day when everything's so good, like I was mentioning yesterday, this is that day. You have all the energy you need. You can get anything done. It's an amazing day 8. See you all on day 9. Let's continue this fabulous journey. Bye bye. Hello guys. So it's day 9 and it's 10:13 the night. So because I went out today, it was really, really hot. So I was kind of dehydrated because I was at a place where I couldn't use the loo. So I was dehydrated, and when I came back home, I think it was so hot that I was exhausted. I just went off to sleep. I slept for literally 4 hours, and I felt so better after that. I had this little, I was feeling short breath like that. So after that, there was no issues at all, and it felt awesome. But now that I've slept for 4 hours, I don't know if I'll be able to sleep at night or I'm going to be staying awake till late. But yeah, that was it. And I mean, one thing you realize is when you're doing a water fast, if you put yourself in any stress situation, a stressed situation, it kind of it gets difficult. You start feeling fidgety and agitated. That's what I was feeling today. So it was uncomfortable, and I took a nap, I think, for the first time in these 9 days. I hadn't taken a nap so far, but I took a nap and it felt really refreshing. So I just went down for a stroll, no walk, nothing, just a light stroll. And tomorrow's day 10, and yes, for the girls, the Aunt Flo arrived, so I feel slightly different and all that. But yeah, tomorrow's day 10. Let's see if I want to weigh myself or if I don't want to weigh myself. If I will check how much I weigh, it's something I'll decide tomorrow. So yeah, day 9 done and done. Day 10. Shh. Hi, so sorry I hadn't updated in the morning for day 10. But yeah, it was kind of mixed day. First, I had to go out again today. It was blazing hot. So that took a toll on me. Again, I was very, very tired. I was in a really bad shape by the time I came back. Second thing was a mistake from my side. I think I was a little careless about taking my electrolytes, the quantity that I have to take with water. I didn't take that. So of course that does affect, So I was a little dizzy today. I had to again take my electrolytes, and I was replenished and I was fine after a nap. So that was on the physical front, but on the emotional front, I had a bad day. Hi guys, so this is day 12. I didn't make a vlog yesterday because unfortunately in my society there were two cases of corona that were found out, and it was something very scary because I've got two little girls and they're about 2 and 4. And so we shifted to Jaipur, say hi to my husband. So they were 2 and 4, so then we decided we would go down to Jaipur. That's my hometown. So we're here currently in Jaipur. So yesterday all day went in packing, and today all day went in traveling. But luckily, I would say by God's grace, there was no stress as such in traveling. Maybe I was very happy going home. So yeah, no stress as such. The journey was pretty comfortable. And yeah, the day 12 continues and it's going really well. And I'm looking forward to the journey furthermore. I'll keep you updated. Hello guys, the day 13 continues. The update for today is I can't drink water. I just can't get that thing down my throat. So I'm actually having it in this form. It has a bit of apple cider vinegar and some pinch of sea salt and the electrolytes, of course. And it's too metallic for my flavor. So that's the update. I'm drinking water, but it's difficult. It's literally, I have to do something or the other. So apple cider vinegar and salt are keeping it down me. Electrolytes are fine. I'm actually in Jaipur. That's my hometown. I belong to Noida, just in case people don't know, which is a part of Delhi capital region, Delhi NCR. And because of the corona outburst, I've left it and I'm here in my hometown, Jaipur. And the weather is outrightly amazing. For this kind of a journey, this weather is outrightly brilliant. And it's an amazing time, having a good time on the journey. Let's see how far we go along. The skin has been healing pretty well. No complaints on that front. Yeah, there are some of them that's going to take a little more time, they're a little more bumpy and all, but for the rest of it's pretty good. So yeah, let's check out late in the day, and I've got to wear my seat belt. So day 13 and day 14 both have a new update. So last night I ended up having a terrible, terrible, terrible migraine. And the worst thing about water fast is you can't take a medicine. So the only option that I was left with is I was turning, toiling the whole night, and all I could do was apply some vapor rubs and
your tiger balms and everything to kind of relax me there. It did take time. In the morning also I had migraine, it continued. Then I felt I was a little gassy in the morning, and usually they say if you have a migraine or a headache, take an enema. So I took an enema, and boy, don't ask me what went in and what came out. So yeah, I did an enema, and after that I felt way better, like the migraine disappeared, everything was good. And the problem with the water still continues, not able to drink water. Only way I'm able to drink water is one cap of apple cider vinegar, like a little, it's a little acidic, and then I'm able to drink it down. I'm having my electrolytes as well. Yeah, in spite of having my electrolytes, my calf muscles are paining. I haven't done any exercise or anything. I just take a stroll for 2-3 kilometers these days because I don't have that kind of energy. But yeah, in spite of that, my calf muscles are paining. My hand is also paining holding this phone. And not only that, I'm out of breath, if you can see, which is very normal. And other than that, day 13, day 14 have been going pretty well. How far will I go? I don't have a number in mind. But let's see. It's a memorable journey. So let's take it further along. So that's the update for day 13, 14. Yes, this new booger came. It happened when my cycle started. So yeah, my cycles have just ended. So hopefully this booger should go. Some things come with natural being a woman. Yeah, so that's it for day 13 and 14. And if there's any update, let's do it tomorrow. Hi guys, the update for day 16 and 17. I didn't do an update yesterday, but the basic thing is still the water's not palatable. It kind of has this really weird taste on my mouth. I mean, I'm hating the taste of water. Also, I mean, usually when you do water fast, you get this white like coating on your tongue, which luckily is gone. Like I don't have that really white cast. So I won't say I'm completely out of, you know, the toxins are out. I'm sure there's something or the other. This acne is present, but I'm okay with that. I know why it's happening, because the main hormonal acne that I was really concerned about was these. These are pretty sorted, so I think, you know, it's going to be better from now on. And yeah, now I'm kind of getting the feel that I'm done with it. I mean, you know, when your body tells you that done, you've done your journey, it's good enough. Let's go back to, you know, where we started in a more disciplined way. So yeah, it's been a good journey. So I think I might open my fast tomorrow. Tomorrow is day 18. So I started my fast around 6 or so, or on the day that I started. So the moment I touched that, it's going to be complete 18 days. So tomorrow morning, I'm going to do my weigh-in. And yes, I open my fast tomorrow. So let's talk tomorrow. I'm pretty much done with this. I'm through and through. Will I ever do this long fast? Can't say. But for now, I just want to eat something. So yeah, that's the update for day 16, day 17. The machine. So now I'm doing my weigh-in again. And let's see how much that is. So I'm going to get down now. So that's an 80.3. That's an overall loss of 8 kilos in 18 days. Which is a good start for a journey. So I'm really happy. And I can go on yada, 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 yada. But I think it's a good start. And I'm really, really excited, and I'm really happy to be going for my journey from here on in a very professor mode. So really happy for you guys to be part of my journey, and I will do a little a longer briefing in the beginning or the ending of my video. I'll make a separate video of the benefits of I had from this water fast. But really excited. 8 kilos in 18 days, that's nothing short of an achievement. And that's it. Thank you. My first meal after 18 days, and it's a spinach soup pureed to the tea, and the dollop of ghee, and I'm kind of a little, I don't know, it's a mixed feeling, you know, like not eating food for so many days, and then you get a morsel to eat, you feel the value of food in life, you know how important it is.